Did you guys ever watch the puzzle videos?
Yeah, I saw a couple of those puzzle videos. Yeah.
Yeah, I used to watch those. They were so palled out that it was
maybe that's why it wasn't appealing, because of the shitty footage and the music. Like, I mean, it makes sense, right?
Yeah.
It was dope though. I love the skaters.
Nothing again. I'm just saying, like, back then.
Yeah.
I think there was some ethnocentrism kind of going on too in the U.S. You know, like people, like you didn't want to, like, nothing outside of the U.S. was cool for a really long time in skateboarding.
That was totally true. You know? Yeah.
Very far few in between. Yeah. Very selective in who we really pay attention to.
Very selected people would come out of there, right?
Yeah.
Like a little bit of Brazil, little bit of Canada, couple people from Europe and.
Yeah, it was like Moses Saccone and like
Colin McKay.
Colin McKay.
Yeah, Carl Shipman. There's a few dudes that were definitely Tom Penny. That stood out.
Yeah.
Penny,
like, Rowley, he like knocked the doors down though. Ooh, he was like, there was nobody. Like, there was, it's so crazy how there's always like amazing talent, but then there's these individuals, like, you get one every like 5 years or so that is just so like on a different plane. And, it's weird because when you try to talk to kids who are like, shit, like 30 or younger now, you can't, like, to try to explain what Penny was, like how insanely, like, incredible and unique his skating was.
It's like a myth. It's like this legend who you would just see. It's like the unicorn, right? You just you never see him, but when you do, it's like magical.
Dude, today's his birthday randomly.
Hey, happy birthday.
No way.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Wow.
But it's amazing though. You'll see these younger kids come around. I see them around here. You'll see these kids that just emulate his style. Like they love Penny and they'll dress like Penny from back in the day. Hmm. And I love that because they're doing their homework.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I just,
there are those kids.
Like the keeping
there are those kids.
Yeah. Keeping it alive, you know?
Crazy to think that Andy Anderson and Tom Penny have the same birthday.
Tom Penny and Tim Olsen.
Wow. Oh wow!
Tim's birthday. Too?
Tim's birthday today.
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, happy birthday, Timmy, Andy, and Tommy. Yeah. Oh, incredible. But they're all those kids. I mean, like I look at the same thing that you're talking about right now is like a Tiago, right?
Right.
This guy. Right. There's so much talent out there, but this guy Tiago comes in, and you're like. Oh, wow.
Such an anomaly. Yeah.
Different level, different shit. You're just like, this guy's phenomenal.
Yeah.
Wow. Down.
It's rad too, because he's just like a nice, like, seems like I don't know him personally, but he seems like a really nice, humble, like, you know, good dude.
That's exactly.
Totally. Right there. Sure. Completely is. And lets his skating do the talking.
Yeah. And loves the past. Yeah. Does the, you know, I think he just loves it.
The Penny thing though, to me, he was such a character. He was like you said, there was so much mystery to this guy that was like, you know, he didn't talk. He didn't seem to talk. Right. You know what I mean?
And there was no interviews stuff back then either.
Yeah.
You just see a photo or video of him skating.
Totally.
Did you see him at Tampa back in the day?
Yeah. Paul Zitzer was, I was like good friends with him back then. He lived in Tampa. And Paul was kind of like, I think I mentioned this in the last nightclub episode, but he kind of like, I feel like he was like the barometer. He was my barometer for what was cool. You know what I mean? Like I was younger. I was like 5 years younger than Paul maybe. Mm. And he's just so funny and had like, to me, he had good taste and he would always be like, oh, you know, Tom Penny, you have to like, this dude is, and he was Tom's biggest fan. So when Tom came to Tampa for a, oh God, what was that brand? What was the brand he and Donnie Barley rode for? And it was a clothing brand. And Jordan Richter.
What?
Whoa, TSA?
Random. Not TSA. TSA.
Oh, it was TSA. Yeah.
Oh, TSA. Yep.
There was a random TSA demo at the skate park in Tampa. And then I think a week or 10 days later, there was a pro contest. So they came and did a demo. And that's when, I think that's when Tom had a broken hand. And he skated the demo. And just did like no flip tricks for like an hour, but his hand was like, it looked like a balloon. It looked like a prop from a movie. And then he just decided to start going in. And I was like, I didn't care how annoying I was. I just followed him everywhere. Everywhere he went, I filmed everything he tried and did that whole day. And then he came, I think they went somewhere like down, you know, like down south for like the week and then came back for Tampa Pro. And it was the same thing. I filmed, he like switched back lip the handrail, which Never seen anybody do that ever. Oh. And I filmed, he probably did it 30 times. I filmed every single one. I was there with the fish. I just like anything he did, I just thought he was the sickest, like most, you know, the most unique dude out.
That was like, that was like 96 or something, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Where is this footage?
I've put, I actually put all of it on our YouTube channel.
Oh, you have?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Just like, it was like, something like, you know, unseen Tom Penny.
Okay. I don't know, I've probably seen all of it then on Cult of Tom.
Right, right. It's like he was doing like, you know, just the classic every single, you know, the classic Penny tricks.
Front side over flip, that pyramid. Kickflip shifties, all that stuff.
He did he did Nolly Backswing 80 melon. I don't know my grabs.
Me neither.
I filmed so much vert in my, when I was younger, I should know all of it. But yeah. Nolly 180 stale fish or Nolly, but he did Nolly Backs 180 stale fish over the pyramid and came back and did, he was, but yeah.
Sick. Yeah. What a crazy time back then, dude.
I know.
It's cool that you knew to follow him.
Yeah. Thankfully. Yeah. Thankfully at the time. He actually, you guys might, when I start telling stories I've already told, just stop me because I'm...
No,
you're good.
They're great, like, man.
I've told this during the pro contest, you know, I'd already been like obsessing over him the whole time he was there. And then during somebody's run, I looked over and that's when the vert ramp was still inside the indoor, you know, skate park at Tampa Park. And he was over on the vert ramp and he was rolling up to the coping by himself, like looking over the... And it, like he was going to try something
like, and I trek started into, I was, from the yeah. deck into the vert ramp.
Yeah. And so just by himself. And so I'm like trying, you know how those contests are. It's like it's like being in like Disney World and trying to get, you know, just to get like right there takes like, you know, all this like climbing over people. And I was like, oh my, get me over there. And he rolled up, he took a push and tried to nolly backside flip into the vert ramp to fakie off the flat. Perfect, like first try, nolly flip, catches it, carries it down and kicks it away and runs backwards down the ramp. Jeez. And then starts going up the stairs. And I'm trying, just like clawing through people to try to get over that, to be able to film him try it. And he tried one more, same thing. Like he could have put it down, but kicked it away and then just like left or whatever.
What? Could you imagine? Nolly backside flipping from the deck into vert ramp.
Yeah, landing into the transition.
With no,
and running backwards down the vert ramp.
Just like, by yourself.
Like, dude. Not even slamming.
Yeah.
Like running out of it.
That's more, almost just as impressive, right? It's like getting out of it.
Again, doing it for free.
There was another weird, I was at that some park in San Diego and Tony Hawk was skating. Just another one of those, as a filmer, just you find yourself sometimes in these just random ass places. And Tony Hawk was skating a vert ramp outside and Muska ended up, he was on the deck. I used the clip in something, but, and then Tom Penny starts skating vert with him with no pads. And Tom's doing like, he does full cabs. He did that and he was trying to do nolly backside flip on the, like, on vert, so he was like at the coping. So he was coming up and trying to do nolly backside flip and come back in. But it's just sick because it's him, Muska, and Tony Hawk skating together. And Tony does a line, and he lands, and as he hops out, Muska's there, and he has the classic kit on and everything. It's probably I think 95.
Oh,
and gives him a high five. It's so sick.
Wow.
It's funny because I feel like every skater from like our generation has a Tom Penny story. You know, it's just, it's like classic.
I just watched it, dude. I just watched everything from afar. I met him once.
Yeah.
Do you have any Tom Penny stories?
Yeah, I tell it all the time, man. He knew my name. I couldn't believe it. No, but I do have one that was when we were at MACBA. We were all sitting around. I'll tell it quickly. We were all sitting around. You know, MACBA, you're chilling in kind of groups. There's like one up there. And then when we were chilling kind of by the street area, we're all hanging Danny LeBron, his suit, whatever. And Tom, and you know, MACBA's a circus, just crazy. So you go up into MACBA, and there's the ramp that goes up, right? Tom Penny gets up, skates, you know, just like this nonchalant over to the little ramp thing, does a ollie's up and does a manual. I swear to God, this sounds ridiculous. The whole MACBA stops. You know, when you know those like TV shows or movies where it's going, that person's going in real time, but everybody else is frozen around and like slow mo looking. Soccer balls are in the air, like slow mo. I swear to God, he ollied up there. Everybody turned and watched him. And he just went around and manualed and landed. And right when he landed, I swear, it was like back. It was back to normal.
Everybody's just waiting for him to do anything.
It was, I swear to God.
What year
I
was
can't
that?
Explain this.
You remember what year that was?
I don't know.
That's when you were living out there for 3 months?
Or yeah.
Just to, I'll tie in the our previous guy we were talking about with the current. I was at South Bank in London randomly, probably this is after I have to base everything in my life on static videos. You know what I mean? Because I know
sure.
I have a bad memory. So I just remember the date, the year each one came out. So this is probably 2005, I think.
Okay. After Static what?
This is after Static 2 had come out.
Okay.
Because I was, but for some reason I was in London and hanging out with Shire. And I can't remember who else, but there's like a whole, the whole squad, like this dude, Jake Sawyer, who's like awesome dude, and Seth Curtis. I'm trying to remember. It doesn't matter. Anyways, all these local dudes, like London locals who worked at Slam City and stuff. And we're just like, oh, let's go to this. Let's go get dinner. And we're walking, and Tom Penny was at South Bank, and we're walking, and I'd seen Paul Shire talking to Tom, and then we're walking, and Tom's walking kind of back. And I was like, dude, there's no way he's coming with us, is he? And then as we keep getting, he ends up joining up, and him and Paul are talking, and then we get to the restaurant and he comes in. I'm like, holy shit, I'm gonna eat dinner with Tom Penny. And it's this place called Wagamama, and they have these really long, it's like the style where you sit at a really long picnic table, you know, so you just, you don't have your own tables.
Gotcha.
So we sat in a group, and Tom sat like eight people, the distance of like 8 to 10 people away for some reason. So we're all sitting here. He just sat way down there. And I don't know why. Maybe he felt uncomfortable, but he's friends with Paul, so that's why he came with. So anyways, we're eating, and I ordered gyozas.
Mm-hmm.
And this is my only like personal one-on-one Tom Penny story. And I haven't spoken a word to him. And I get my gyozas, and I'm like, all right. I get my little chopsticks, and I just get ready to pick it up, and I feel a presence, and I turn, and it's just Tom, and he's standing right over my shoulder. And he's like this. He's like, what's that? And I'm like, it's a gyoza. And he's like, and I was like, do you want one? He's like, and he just handed him a gyoza. And he ate the gyoza. And I can't remember. He said something, just like one word, like something like, and then just went back and sat down. So bizarre.
Like he had to see what it was. He had to know what it was.
Yeah. I hadn't even been introduced to him. He just like
he a took ghost your food.
Just appeared. That's he was amazing. Just right there.
But he took your so food. Yeah.
Wow.
That's amazing.
Isn't that funny, man? Tom Penny, bro.
Tom Penny.
Eating the gyozas. Legend. In London with Paul Shire, Josh Stewart.
Wow. So good.
What did he have? Did you see what he ordered?
I have no idea. I don't even think he ate, to be honest.
He just ate your gyoza. But you were in the group, and he was sitting 8 people away from you.
Yeah.
Like away, not just 8 people, but like.
Right. There was no people between me and him. He just, for some reason, sat really far away.
There was no one sitting there.
No, it was an empty bench. Wow. He could have sat right next to me the whole time, you know? And that's what I was expecting. I was like, oh shit, Tom Penny's going to sit next to me. But it was strange.
Social
but
distancing.
Still,
yeah, I was about to say social distancing early on.
Early on.
That is so bizarre.
Such a good
Wait,
dude.
Did he go
love,
back?
Love Tom Penny.
Did he go back and sit far away after?
That's my memory. That's what I remember is he went back, but I don't.
So he came and gave your gyoza and then went back 8
and
feet.
He's out.
So
man of mystery.
Man of mystery. Yeah. Bro. That's why everybody's
that's a good story.
That's why everybody's got a Tom Penny story.
Yeah. Where is that like button right? Is it right here or right here?
Just a little scroll coming down the bottom.
It's
subscribe
over to it's on your
it's on my
left.
Right?
No,
my
on
left.
Your left.
Hey,
yeah.
Hit right that there. Button right there.
Right there.
Right there.
Yeah, please.
The like button's kind of like in the right middle there. It's like we're kind of like
oh, it's
there.
Like right here?
Kind of.
Like
yeah,
right there.
The subscribe's like over to the left.
It's like right over there. All right.